congregational singing until someone in authority says we can go ahead. We are, however, allowed to have a small number, and that small number is the choir. So there they are, socially distanced at the back, keeping you safe and well. So here we are, God's people, gathered together in prayer and offering this holy sacrifice. Let us prepare ourselves for these mysteries. Almighty God,
to whom all paths are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, confident in God's forgiveness. Merciful God,
our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear, 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 hear
raised up a fallen world. Fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Your name for
your name.
Father, Lord of heaven and of earth, for hiding these things from the learned and the clever, and revealing them to mere children. Yes, Father, for that is what it pleased you to do. Everything has been entrusted to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, just as no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Expeditions fitting across the shoulders, around the back of the neck, allowing two bags, for example, to be hooked on and carried at each side, wearing a yoke voluntarily because it is helpful, is very different from forcing slaves to bear a yoke and carry terrible burdens. In the Gospel, Jesus used the word yoke in both senses. He is concerned about people who labor and are overburdened. He had in mind some of the strict followers of the Jewish faith whose religious life had become an intolerable burden. Scholars enumerated 613 laws, religious laws, which they enjoined on people to keep. The idea was that by striving to keep all these laws, you made yourself pleasing and acceptable to God. Why not? The effort alone should impress him. A lot of those laws and regulations were to do with washing hands, sanitizing hands, how it should right should be done thoroughly, so perhaps we can relate to some of those burdens and laws. But Jesus rejects such notions of religion. He spoke harsh words about those scribes and Pharisees who tie up heavy burdens, as he puts it, and lay them on men's shoulders. But will they lift a finger to remove them? Not they. Laboring under the humiliating and oppressive burden of a foreign political occupation, their religion gave them no comfort either, but rather piled on burdens of inadequacy, guilt, and failure. After all, was it not their sins and the sins of their forebears that had brought this upon them? And so they cried out to God, trying to deserve his favor, and perhaps treasuring a hope, a promise, an ancient promise that God had not deserted them and one day would intervene. The overburdened people awaited a savior. And Jesus, who in the words of the prophet Zechariah would come triumphant and humble and riding on a donkey, a mystical way of describing the incarnation, the sharing of Jesus in our human life and predicament, inviting those overburdened people who had no hope of observing all the laws completely to, as he put it, come to me. Come to me and follow me, rather than all those rules and regulations devised by the religious leaders. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Those beautiful words sum up the ultimate purpose of our Christian life and faith. It is to find rest for our souls, their true home, where they can finally rest and find comfort, a place of belonging, a place where you can be yourself as you're meant to be. And to underline it, Jesus adds, yes, my yoke is easy and my burden light. His yoke is not the heavy yoke of innumerable laws that must be constantly monitored, but the easy yoke of joyfully following him in order to do his will. We've all experienced something of what it is to live under unfamiliar and sometimes burdensome regulations, restrictions, rules. This time of global pandemic has meant changes for everybody, changes in behavior, changes in what is permitted. Here in Australia, we've got away quite lightly compared to a lot of other countries, not just in terms of the effects of the pandemic, but also the rules that we've had to live under. Some of us have not liked this at all and not coped well. Others have managed better. And we're beginning now to see an easing of the restrictions, perhaps enjoying that pubs and restaurants are doing a roaring trade, and here we are, God's family, in this community of faith, gathered at the usual times, worshipping God, catching up with each other, and being the family of faith that we are. But of course, in other parts of the country, in Melbourne in particular, we know that things have not gone well. There has been a big setback, and rules are being enforced much more severe than any of the rules that we've had to live under. And especially we think of those in high-rise public housing who have been quite strictly locked down, vulnerable people. We need to keep them in our prayers in this coming week. Life will not be easy. So we've experienced something of what it is to live under what might be felt to be oppressive rules, restrictions, unfamiliar regulations, but also things that we need to do and have to do. And we know the relief that comes when we don't have to be constantly monitoring ourselves in that way, just being compliant. Shouldering Christ's easy yoke and learning from him. This is what he tells us to do, not for public health, but for spiritual health. He says that his yoke is easy, but we should not assume that he means that we don't have to do anything. He is asking something of us, but he will not be using force or coercion. And we can do what he wants us to do in all sorts of ways. First of all, by experiencing his gentleness and humility, so that we can love him and realize his love for us. He does not want life to be a burden, but a gift. He may suggest we let go, in some ways, changing our priorities. Maybe like Jesus, who, when he was burdened with the heavy cross, did not insist on carrying it alone, but was glad to have someone help him, Simon of Cyrene. Sometimes it may just mean talking to someone. Trouble shared is trouble halved, is a proverb attributed to Dorothy Sayers. Going to confession relieves the burden of sins and guilt and offers the opportunity to talk with utter confidence and confidentiality to a priest who can offer words of encouragement and the reassurance of absolution. Sadly, there can be periods in life when little can be done to lessen or even share our burdens and anxieties. But in saying, "Shoulder my yoke," Jesus is offering to help us with our burdens. Far from the Lord imposing yet another burden on us, he asks us to come to him. The Lord is kind and full of compassion, as the psalmist says. Come to me, Jesus says. I am gentle and humble of heart. Come to me rather than seeking solace or relief in the ways of this world, often destructive, demeaning. For as St. Paul says in today's second reading, your interests are not in the unspiritual, Jesus answers our prayers when we ask his help. And he gives us the strength to carry on with a peace that comes from the Spirit of Christ living in us. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of our Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he arose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we gather together, let us bring before our Heavenly Father the concerns and needs of our world.
We give you thanks, Lord God, for the good news of salvation for all people. Strengthen us for our work in the world and empower your church to proclaim the gospel in service, word, and sacrament.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we continue to live in the midst of pandemic, we pray for the people of Melbourne, especially remembering those in public housing, high rise in Flemington and North Melbourne, and all places where the virus is growing. We pray for the sick and continue to hold before you all medical and nursing staff, all carers in nursing homes, and those who have responsibility of leadership at this time.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
We thank you, Lord, for the fellowship we share in this community of faith. Help us to continue our Christian journey with hope, always being ready to support one another and to welcome others with love.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
We give thanks that you are the God who brings mercy and wholeness. Strengthen and support all who are sick, especially those who have asked for our prayers. Beth, Wayne, Joan and Howard Butler, Chris Darnell, Janice and Ken Eltham, Jackie Fitzgerald, Terry Fox, Catherine Fremlin, Bill Fremlin, Mike Gibbons, Clary Greaves, Doug and Liz Hamilton, Rosemary Holt, Susan Kinging, Margaret Moles, Miles McClendon, Eva Tay, Esther Locker, Mary Ellen Van Der Geer, and others on our hearts.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
We praise you, Lord God, for all your servants whose lives have honoured Christ. And united with all your saints, we pray for those who've recently died, Betty Murphy, Grace Mackay, Vera Lynn, John Potter, and all whose remembrance falls at this time, Charles Shah, Nina Loder, Lois Mays, Ali Byron, Elaine Rich, Peter Rind, priest, John Cornish, and Mavis Palmer. May we share with them the fullness of joy in your kingdom.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer, hear our prayer.
Lives my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this oblation dedicated to your name purify our soul, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. After supper, he took the cup, and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood, mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, Father, we do as our Savior has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. And looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, St. John, and all your people, into the joy of your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. With whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise.
Blessing and honor and glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Thank you.
place of others called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only to say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. Through Jesus Christ our Lord,
send us out to the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
We are able to offer a special, socially distanced and carefully managed morning tea, so you are welcome to join us, please, for refreshments after the service. At the end of the month, or perhaps at the beginning of next month, really, Sandra and I will have finished 20 years at St. John's. So, to mark that occasion, there is afternoon tea on the 1st of August, a Saturday afternoon, and you are warmly invited to come to that and mark that occasion. There are other notices in the pew sheet. Happy birthday this week to Shane Georgevich, Debbie Roberts, Leonie Wenning, Rosemary Holt, and Chris Dimmick. Anyone else celebrating birthdays or anniversaries this week? Our very best wishes. Well done, choir, together all for the first time. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.